I got interested in environmental issues while I was in the University of Juba majoring in forestry. I started learning about climate change and then mitigation and adaptation. When I graduated, I joined the Agriculture Research Corporation, where I also did experiments on resilient crops and water harvesting. And when South Sudan seceded from Sudan, I relocated to the south, where fortunately I joined the South Sudan Nature Conservation Organization, and I was fortunately selected to attend the General Assembly of HoAREC in Somaliland. After the General Assembly, we are also invited to join the landscape learning journey. In the landscape learning journey, we happened to visit the Morode J landscape in Somaliland, where we learned how people harvested water and to grow crops and to grow pasture for their animals, and how even they migrated to other areas during different seasons, something synonymous to South Sudan. After Morode J, we went and joined a learning journey in Ziwai. In Ziwai, we found the flower growers and how water was an issue in that area. The lake was drying up and people were getting to know how to distribute this water so that the lake is a bit controlled. After that, we went to Soralo, where we also find the Maasai people living in harmony with their animals. And after Soralo, we visited Gambela, where we also visited the Eco Hub, where we learned smart agriculture and chain value. And from there, we went to Asawo landscape in Djibouti, where we saw people how they manage the invasive species like prosopis, and how even they also use the rainwater to grow crops. My story is, when we come to South Sudan, we found that so many people have been displaced and have now settled in Juba. People of different livelihoods, we have the herders, we have the farmers, we have the urban dwellers, and we have the factories, all which have brought food security as a major problem in the city. With that, there is also much deforestation because people need to cook food and to boil their water for their living. We found that also the population that was great brought in mass solid waste, and this disposal was also a problem. So there are so many problems in Juba landscape, and I will say we have learned so many things in this landscape learning journey and from the different landscape that we visited. And if we really continue with the HoAREC, we wanted to put the practicality or the practice of what we have learned into use in our landscape of Juba, so that we could alleviate food security in Juba and garbage disposal in Juba itself. We also want to introduce new stuff so that it can reduce deforestation, which is so rampant in Juba, and this is our story in Juba landscapes. Thank you very much.